I can already tell it's gonna be yummy.
I hope so. I hope so.
Now, Grandma, when you were little, did you ever twist the little stalk off the apple and say the ABCs, and then you'd find out who your true love would be?
No, but I've heard of things like that, too. But no. That'd be okay.
Grandma, did you know that certain fruit trees, they say, have associations with the planets? Like the apple is supposed to be associated with the planet Venus for love of your family and friendship.
I've always heard that about friendship.
Yep.
And especially about the pineapple.
You've heard that? The pineapple, the coconuts, and peach trees. Those are all fruits of the planet Venus.
Isn't that something?
And normally people think about, when they think about an apple, they think about the Adam and Eve story.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I do.
Okay, rolling it out again.
Rolling it again, because it's very short. Put a lot more flour down there.
You know, the Native Americans, they symbolize the apple tree as the tree of heaven.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. And in Eastern Europe, people, when somebody has a baby, they'll go plant an apple tree.
I've heard of that. Yeah, I've heard of that. I've heard of that.
In honor of that new baby.
Mm-hmm. But I've got a crab apple that you guys got me, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I love that.
Ooh, that crab apple. She made some crab apple jelly. That is just the best. I had my peanut butter and jelly sandwich for lunch today.
I just love that.
It's so good.
It's tart.
So you think crab apples are the best way to go when you're making your jellies?
Jelly. Now, they are not good for baking an apple pie. Crab apples aren't.
They're not good for...
For pie. You can't even... They're not even good to stew. But they're very good for jelly. And now we're going to put it in the plate, hopefully. It's very short.
Ooh, looks good.
Hope it is.
Now, Grandma, that takes a little talent right there, doesn't it?
Yeah, when it's this short. And the reason I have it so short is that's what makes good pie crust. If it's tough, you wouldn't like it. Nobody likes old tough pie crust. You like it where it just melts in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why it's so short. Because that's what I want. Okay, now we've got it in the bottom. And now we're going to put the apples in. And what I like to do, our apples are cut up and everything. I like to put my sugar in, cinnamon and nutmeg and a little bit of flour. And then mix it all in here, and then put it in my crust, okay?
Okay.
So that's what we're going to do here now. Oh, it's a cup of sugar. And a teaspoon of nutmeg, and a teaspoon of cinnamon, or a teaspoon and a half. I always put a little bit more. And then 2 tablespoons of flour. And you put, like you put this in your bowl. This is the way we do it. I hope everybody can see this. You just mix it all up.
Oh, it smells so good. Do I smell the nutmeg?
Nutmeg and the cinnamon. I think cinnamon makes it smell good too. A lot of people can put nuts in their pie, too, like pecans or walnuts. What? I never do, but a lot of people do the old-fashioned way. They just have apples.
All right, she's mixing it up real good. And that's the apples, and the cinnamon, the nutmeg, and the sugar.
You're right, Rowdy. Just about ready. Now we're putting it in the pie shell. I've already got the oven on, and I set it on 375. I bake it 25 minutes and then look at it. I always have a foil around the edge.
And that's to keep the crust from
overgrowing. Mm-hmm. And then after 25 minutes, I take that foil off, bake it 25 more minutes so it's good and brown. And it good looking, Missy. Ooh,
that's so pretty.
We love that, don't we?
And so, ooh, that looks so good.
I hope this is
don't you wish you had some?
Okay, now I'll roll out this other.
So now this is the top, right?
This is the top.
And so there's no rules, are there, Grandma? You can just put it in there.
Any way you want to. You can cut it up and make it crisscross
strips.
You know, mm-hmm.
I like the way you do it, though.
You like everything.
I know. I like everything Grandma makes.
Yes, you do. And your husband does too.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
Yummy! It looks so
now,
good.
When that's baked, see some of this apple juice will come up. Mm-hmm. When that's baked, it'll look like it's all one.
So we're fixing to put it in the oven. Okay. Yummy, Grandma. Yummy. Okay, she's putting it in the oven now.
I'm going to put my foil on it.
She's putting her foil. Okay.
Can you see?
See how she put it around the edge so that it doesn't over brown? Okay. Yay.
Yay.
Okay, so we're cleaning up the mess. And Grandma, I see you got some flour on you.
Here we are. Yes.
Which I think that always makes it better. You know, the pie's going to be better because we've got it all over us. And I hadn't even done anything.
And you know what? We're twins.
We're matching.
Yes.
That's right.
Isn't that wonderful?
That's wonderful.
And oh, we forgot to mention the red hots.
Grandma's eating red hots. What was she going to say, Grandma?
They put the red hots in for taste and for it gave the apple butter and applesauce a nice, beautiful pink color. It's red hots.
Red hots.
And this is a wooden rolling pin. This was my mother's. I think they're heavier. That's what makes them a good pin.
Okay. Is that the only thing you can use them for? Is
you know, you can hit your husband in the head. If he doesn't behave.
I need one of those, Grandma. This one. So, I take it you never had to use your rolling pin for your hubby, though.
I should. No.